And now the winner of Best Solo Performance. John, you've got three names. What are they?
John Douglas Thompson. It used to be just John Thompson, but because of equity, there's another John Thompson somewhere, and I couldn't use that name.
It's like a Nika Noni Rose. Just sounds so.
I think three names are in this year.
Yeah, it
sounds
works.
So grand and so noble, right?
I haven't seen your show, but I'm going to very shortly, and it's a great honor to meet you, sir.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it.
I'm thrilled to be having you here in such flattering lighting. We've all turned red, I think.
It's makeshift.
We've broken the color barrier.
It's makeshift.
Okay.
Yes, yet again.
Yet again.
Because in the show, I have to play a Jewish guy.
No.
I play Armstrong's manager. His name is Joe Glazer.
Okay.
And he's a Jewish guy. He's a mobster. And him and Armstrong had a 40-year relationship, meaning they were together as client and manager for 40 years. And they both made each other extremely wealthy, of course. Armstrong made Glazer wealthy, and Glazer booked a lot of great jobs for Armstrong and made Armstrong wealthy. So that's acted out in the play. It's really their relationship.
That's a story. That's a story and a half.
Yeah, because a lot of people don't know about Glazer.
I never heard of him before.
Yeah, and he was a big manager for a lot of jazz musicians.
Drink your water if you want to. You're allowed.
He managed Billie Holiday. He managed Duke Ellington, Lionel Hampton, B.B. King. Quite a few people that we're very familiar with, right? Icons in that field. He was their manager, and he was considered to be one of the better managers in the music industry because he always got his clients gigs and he always got his clients money.
Well, they're an awesome group, and we've all heard of them. So he was very good at what he did.
He was, and he came up through Al Capone. I mean, Al Capone. He was one of Al Capone's guys, and he worked with Al Capone. Back in the 30s and 40s in Chicago, south side of Chicago, running a lot of the clubs there, which is where a lot of jazz musicians went to play, right, south side of Chicago. So that's how Armstrong met Joe Glazer. And they formed a relationship from that moment and remained together for the rest of their lives.
I've always loved Louis Armstrong. I always loved him. Louis, yeah.
Yeah, and that's, a lot of people love Armstrong. And as a matter of fact, he never liked people calling him Louis.
Oh. Oops, sorry, Louis.
No, that sounded too French. He wanted to be called Louis. And we make a point of that in the show. We talk about, because he talks about his name. And if you listen to Hello, Dolly.
Yes, I was just going to say.
This is Louis. He really makes a point of it. Because
she says that, yeah.
Yeah, so it's, and that's what he wanted his name to be. But, everybody after a while got to know him as Louis, and then they just throwing it around.
At such a time, the manager is speaking of all of those clients, the battles he must have had to fought for them, booking basically African-American talent into white clubs.
Yeah.
What a story. I can't wait to see your play.
And that's the story of many of those musicians at that time, because the music business, the jazz music business, was run by a lot of these mobsters, and they control the clubs, so they control the outlets for the musicians, So it was one of those things where if you were a jazz musician, let's say in the 20s and 30s and even 40s and maybe even up to the 50s, you wanted to play in certain clubs, you had to have a relationship with someone who had a relationship with the mob, and they can open that door for you. And so Glazer was always affiliated with the mob, even when he kind of went clean, He always still had mob connections to get things done if he needed them done. And Armstrong, I think, kind of knew that, and Armstrong benefited from it, but Glazer also benefited from Armstrong's talents.
Now, you're playing in one of my favorite theaters in New York. Let's tell them where it is.
It's the West Side Theater on 43rd and 9th. It's beautiful,
it's
very
intimate.
Cozy, intimate theater, because the show's intimate.
So if you go to see Satchmo at the Waldorf, you're going to feel this close to this great, great, honored performer.
You'll feel as if Satchmo is spitting on you.
Okay.
Not
all
that.
Right.
You'll just feel, you'll be that close to Satchmo. You can see moisture coming out of his mouth.
All right. It always did. I always noticed
there
that.
There you go. So, you'll be that close with this show.
Well, listen, thank you for stopping by today here at the Drama Desk Awards on the Stephen Holt Show. There it is right on the table.
Stephen Holt, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Appreciate it.